Hello, everyone, and welcome to Top of Mind. If I had to talk about the last 3 years in AI, I'd say that 2023 was the year of this shiny new thing. 2024 was the year of innovating all over the enterprise and letting a thousand flowers bloom. And 2025 is the year of AI value. AI's actually following the Gartner hype cycle. We had the initial boom, then we hit the peak of inflated expectations, and now we're headed for the trough. Executives ask me every day, where is this amazing value that AI was supposed to deliver? And they're getting impatient. Back in the spring, I did a Top of Mind video on how there are three types of AI value, and it's worth revisiting those now. The three types of AI value are return on investment, return on employee, and return on the future. In other words, AI is not just an ROI play. So what's return on employee? Return on employee is about individual employee productivity. This is you using AI to summarize a meeting or translate it into Spanish. Lots of executives are searching for the massive cost savings associated with increased productivity. And that has proved elusive for a number of reasons. First of all, it turns out that productivity is one of the hardest things to measure and track. Second of all, time saved does not equal money saved because of something called productivity leakage. If I save 30 minutes in a day because of AI, what am I doing with that time? Working harder or going to get a latte? I'm not going to answer that, and maybe you shouldn't either. But there is a return here. It's just not directly financial. So executives would be better off looking at employee engagement. Employee engagement goes up when employees use personal AI productivity tools. And of course, this has an indirect financial benefit. That's return on engagement. The second kind of AI value is indeed return on investment, what everybody's talking about. The first thing to know is that only focusing on productivity will not bring ROI. That requires deep process change, integrating AI into your workflow. So this is, for example, an insurance company transforming their underwriting process using AI, or a bank changing their credit process, or a manufacturing company using AI to change their track and trace process. The problem here is that companies are dabbling. They're sprinkling a little AI at the beginning or at the end of the process and waiting for magical things to occur. And that's not how this works. You need deep process redesign, deep understanding of what AI can do and what it can't do, deep understanding of your data, and someone who's really close to the work actually being done every day. That's return on investment. The third kind of AI value is return on the future. Not all of you are going to pursue this kind of value because it's risky. This is where you're using AI to rewrite the rules of your industry. So you're not getting better at playing the game, you're changing the game. And lots of executive leaders I talk to say that they want this kind of game-changing innovation, and who wouldn't? It sounds super sexy. But my experience with return on the future ideas is that they're deeply unsexy and unglamorous. It's really hard and kind of lonely to pursue a vision that nobody else can see. When you're doing this, you're failing most of the time, and you're asking for more money when the last round of investment hasn't paid off yet. So it's really tough. A lot of enterprises are going to opt out of return on the future ideas, and that's just fine. The critical thing is to not opt out of watching what others are doing with AI and being a super fast follower at a minimum if someone in your industry makes a change that you need to react to. That's return on the future. So what kind of value should you pursue? The answer is to manage AI investments like a portfolio. So don't ask, should we give everybody Copilot or Google Gemini or whatever? Do ask, how do we invest across these categories? So to wrap it all up, what we're seeing with AI value follows our hype cycle projections, and 2025 is we're headed for the trough. Revisit your ambitions, Remember that productivity does not equal value, and consider the business outcomes of not just ROI, but ROE, and for some of you, ROF as well. To learn more about AI value, follow the links in the notes and be sure to attend Gartner IT Symposium Expo this fall to hear more. Thanks very much, and I'll see you next time.